And so the overview of our show, and so we're going to do kind of a different take because this book is kind of so laden with examples, and they're really good examples.
Yeah,
we'd almost be reading the book. And so what we want to do, and what Tony has done here, is kind of pulled out the main nuggets of detail without the examples. Not that those examples aren't important.
We'll use a few of the examples, especially when we really need to.
Right. It's, we're not going to just avoid it for the sake of not understanding. But we always want this to be a book club. We want you to read it along with us. Mm-hmm. We want you to kind of understand the main points from within it. So we've always viewed the show as a compendium to the books. That's why we always link the books in each episode. And so kind of what we're doing here is maybe it's going to take a couple chapters in an episode, and we're distilling it down. But there's a lot of material that he does cover and a lot of examples that he does, because these are tactical. These are specifics on how to handle different types of situations.
So, what do I say in this particular situation, right? And how do I communicate that and that sort of thing? When this person says this, what was the best response to that and those sorts of things?
So again, not devoiding of examples, not taking away from the book. This is just a different way for us to present it. And who knows? Maybe you like it. Maybe you don't. Maybe you want us to do something different. Yeah. There's always comments. There's always Patreon that you can always do. Patreon.com/Cave of the Cross.
So let us know.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. kind of the introduction to this book, he says he's got a promise for us. The promise is this. I'm going to give you a game plan that will allow you to converse with confidence in any situation. Okay, all righty, good. No matter how little you know, or how knowledgeable or aggressive or even obnoxious the other person might be.
Wow.
So, you know, I don't remember what the Council of Chalcedon said about the Trinity and, you know, 1604 or, you know, whenever it might be. You have that friend that does, and he knows all the church councils and what each side argued against. Yes, we should learn. Obviously, Christians are a reading bunch. That's what this show hopes to encourage, is for you to read and dust off those theology books like this one that you may have had on your shelf or been given as a gift. There's no doctorate that you need in order to engage with just a conversation with people about your faith. And so, it's always good to know more, because there might be people that say, well, what about all the changes in the Bible? Or didn't Constantine really allow books to be thrown out of the Bible? And we lost some things. every book by Bart Ehrman, you know, there's always the popular Bart Ehrman, and there's the legitimate Bart Ehrman. You know, those are two different characters. And so, you know, everyone can just throw out, well, Bart Ehrman says, well, okay, you know, what does he say? And so this is more of a on the front lines. And in this first part of the chapter, he kind of makes it synonymous with kind of a battle plan.
Yeah. So, you know, we'll be able to converse with confidence, he tells us, in any situation.
Right.
So that's and I think that's a kind of a huge thing to kind of back up, right? I mean, he's making a promise here of what he's going to attempt to accomplish with us. So I guess we need to hang on and see if he can, you know, if he can back up his promise, right?
Right. Yeah. Colossians 4, and I took it a verse back, 3-6 says, pray also for us that God may open to us a door for the word to declare the mystery of Christ, on account of which I am in prison, that I may make it clear, which is how I ought to speak, walk in wisdom towards outsiders, making the best use of the time. Let your speech always be gracious, seasoned with salt, so that you may know how you ought to answer each person.
Yeah, so that's Colossians 4, right?
Yep, Colossians 4, 3-6. And so what Greg Koukl is doing is kind of following Paul's plan here. He has kind of three main points that he pulls out of this one, or that we can derive from scripture that he also will cover in this book. The first one is be smart, walk in wisdom, as it says in verse 5 there. Also be nice. Paul says to be gracious and be tactical. Know how to answer each person. It seems like, you know, Paul's not this person that says, well, the Holy Spirit will reach out and move that person in such a way that no matter what you might say, that's good enough. And so it's kind of this esoteric, high-minded view of I'm just there as the body and I'm moving in the water. No, he's saying that we should
walk in wisdom and be smart. Yeah.
We should know things, but we shouldn't just, stop. Yeah. And say, well, the Lord can use me at my worst. So that's where I should be.
Lord can, right? And right. often does, right?
But we
need to be prepared as well, right?
Right.
We need to be good instruments for the Lord to use, right? Right. Sharp instruments.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. And Christ tells us about this, too, that we're going to cover later of just how to be wise as serpents and gentle as doves. And, Jesus is telling us that too. I mean, we should listen. Be nice. Our attitude matters. How we present the gospel matters in the way that people respond. And you don't want to be
an angry apologist, right?
Your own thorn in people's sides. Yeah. You don't want to be high minded. I know this, and you don't. And look at you. And atheists can't have morals. You're just all fornicating fools or whatever it might be. And also know how to how you ought to answer each person. So people are different, and so it might make sense for you to cover the problem of evil with someone, but it might also be someone who's struggling with money and doesn't understand how a loving God could want someone who has given so much time and energy and has a family of six to raise by themselves. Why does that matter? And so knowing your audience is important, and Paul tells us, and God is able to use us at our worst, but we shouldn't just stay there.